Okay, so here we are doing preparation of salts. For this, we are referring the solubility charts. These are soluble salts, sodium, potassium, ammonium, and all nitrates. So you remember the word SPAN, SPAN. All sodium salts are soluble, potassium salts are soluble, all ammonium salts are soluble, and all nitrates, which is a negative ion, they are also soluble. All chlorides will be soluble. Lead chloride is insoluble, silver chloride is insoluble. All sulfates also will be soluble. The insoluble sulfates are barium sulfate, calcium sulfate, which is sparingly soluble, and lead sulfate. Okay, of course, we have seen here SPAN, so all of these carbonates also will be soluble. Rest all carbonates will be insoluble. All group 1 metal phosphates, sodium, potassium, and so on, will be soluble. Even ammonium, as we have seen in SPAN, they will be soluble. Rest all the phosphates are going to be insoluble. Then we are coming to hydroxides. Again, we are applying the same thing. SPAN, sodium, potassium, ammonium will be soluble, and magnesium hydroxide is very sparingly soluble. Even this calcium hydroxide as well. Rest all hydroxides are going to be insoluble. Now the salt that we are preparing is silver chloride. As we have seen here, all nitrates are soluble, so obviously the silver salt which is going to be there will be silver nitrates. Now the other part over here is chloride. So we have to choose some such salt because the reaction is precipitation. We have to choose some such salt which is going to be soluble. Obviously, we have seen here SPAN, SPAN, sodium potassium. So we can use over here sodium chloride or potassium chloride. So here I'm going to write sodium chloride. The next part of the question, neutralization. We are using here zinc carbonate. Obviously, the salt that is going to be there, it is going to start with the word zinc. The acid is sulfuric acid, so the salt produced is going to be sulfate. You can take down this. If you have any questions, you can ask.